Karibu kwenye kipindi chetu cha fizikia kutana nami Mama Physics kwenye mada za practicals na theory. Okay. Unaweza kunipata kwenye YouTube kwa jina la Mashamba Magurumali ama kwenye WhatsApp kwa kutumia namba 0712579612. Tafadhali usinipigie simu, tuwasiliane kwa njia ya SMS. Okay. In case kama utahitaji notes ama utahitaji somo kwa ajili yako, karibu. Okay. So tunawakilisha practical physics under the simple pendulum. Tulisema kwamba juu ya simple pendulum, theory of the simple pendulum. Tukazungumza simple pendulum is governed by this expression. T is equal to 2 pi under root of L over G. T is equal to 2 pi under root of L over G. So the following are the laws which govern a simple pendulum. Laws of which govern a simple pendulum. There are four laws for which govern the simple pendulum. One, can we call it the law of length? Law of length. In this case, it states that periodic time t of a simple pendulum is proportional to the under root of L, whereby L is the length of a pendulum. Length of a pendulum. So effective length of a pendulum, as we have said, that it can be measured from the center of the bulb to the point of suspension. So L is the effective length of a pendulum. Law number two. The law of gravity. Law of gravity. This is said that a periodic time t is inversely proportional to the under root of g. Inversely proportional to the under root of g. So this is the law of gravity. And also, there is a law of mass. A law of mass, which say that, this is number three, law of mass. The periodic time t is independent. Periodic time t is independent of the mass of the suspended body. Mass of the suspended body. This is the mass which have been suspended to a string. So it is independent of this mass. Let me use this symbol. Mass of the suspended body. Suspended body at the end of the string. Okay, that is the law of mass. And also, the fourth law is said that the law of isochronism. They say that the amplitude does not, periodic time t, sorry, does not depend on amplitude of vibration. Does not depend on amplitude of vibration, although the angular displacement could never exceed 4 degrees. So this is the law of isochronism. T does not depend on the amplitude of vibration, provided that angular displacement theta does not exceed 4 degrees. So these are the four laws of which govern the simple pendulum. Let me see the drawbacks of the simple pendulum. Drawbacks of a simple pendulum. So whenever a simple pendulum is the simplest method for determining the acceleration due to gravity, it suffers with the following defects. Drawbacks. 1. First of all, the condition for defining an ideal simple pendulum are never realizable in practice. Kwamba tumesema kwamba in order to be an ideal simple pendulum, angular displacement must not exceed 0. Kwa hicho kitu, practically it is impossible. And also, the motion of the ball. If we look at the motion of the ball, tumesema kwamba motion of the ball, wakati tuna derive pale, tunasema kwamba the motion of the ball is not purely translational. As you can see here, whenever it moves to and fro, but also it rotates about the mean position. So it possesses also, if it rotates about the mean position, means it possesses the rotational motion. So this is another drawback. And also, the mass, this mass, the string, tumesema kwamba the string is massless or a string of negligible mass. But in fact, the mass of the string is there. Since it is a matter, so it has a mass. And it has a mass. So then, if it is, has a mass, and the particles are distributed from the axis of rotation, so this possess the moment of inertia. Moment of inertia about the axis of rotation. So this is another drawback for the simple pendulum. Okay. A string is an inextensible string. We are using a string which is inextensible. Okay, in real fact, kwamba string is not inextensible. Kwamba kama limit of oscillation ikizidi, manake hii kamba italegea, it can slant. Kama ita slant, manake itaongezeka urefu bila wewe kujua. Kama hivyo basi, manake kwamba effective length of a simple pendulum does not remain at the same always. Kwamba kuna some sort of the effective length of pendulum while swinging about the limiting point, it can change the effective length of a simple pendulum. Okay. Another drawback, tulisema kwamba, it does not depend on the mass of the ball, But in fact, the mass of the ball can be defined. That's why we are using 20 grams or 50 grams for the pendulum ball. Kwamba kama utatumia zaidi hapo manake inawezekana katokea ile damping baada ya sanduku kwamba ule uzito ukasababisha kwamba ile damping oscillation ikatokea. Another drawback, tunasema kwamba whenever the body, let the ball moving to and fro, but also rotates about its axis of rotation. About the suspension point it rotates. So these are the drawbacks, drawbacks of the simple pendulum. Kwa misingi hiyo basi, simple pendulum, katika kutafuta acceleration due to gravity, kwamba hatuwezi tukapata majibu yale halisi zaidi, kwamba 9.8, hatuwezi tukapata hivyo kwa sababu ya hizo drawbacks zake. Otherwise, if we can use a rigid body for determining the acceleration due to gravity, or if we can use a compound pendulum, kwamba hizi defects zinapungua, zipo kidogo ama hazipo kabisa. Okay. So the most of the defects are either absent or much smaller in the case of the rigid or compounding pendulum. So to have a real value of G, maybe if you can use a rigid body or rigid body methods or a compound pendulum, you can have a real value of G. Let me say that, see the causes of errors in simple pendulum. Causes of errors in simple pendulum. The possible causes of errors, one, we are using a time for counting the number of oscillations. We are using a time for counting a number of oscillations. Maybe the reaction time, the time to start and the time to stop swinging. So whenever you start motion of the pendulum, you must start with the stopwatch. Stopwatch or stop clock, whatever. But that's into recorded time. So the time reaction on starting and stopping the motion, it could result in an error due to the simple pendulum. So time reaction. Also, angular displacement may be a source, it can be a source of error. The angular displacement here, remember, for ideal pendulum, the angular displacement must not exceed 4. So that's why we have told you to file to displace with a small angle, displace it with a small angle. So whenever you exceed the angle, means that can provide an error due to a simple pendulum. Another, maybe the environmental factors. Environmental factors here, tunazungumzia humidity, tunazungumzia temperature, tunazungumzia wind. Those are the environmental factors. So for the case of a simple pendulum, so it may be suffered with the wind. If there is a wind blow, it can increase the amplitude of vibration or it can dampen the oscillation. Another one, is the error due to measuring length. Let me say the parallax error in measuring the length. Error in measuring the length. When we measure the length of a string, we are advised to look at the point perpendicular to the point of which you are taking a reading. Your eye must be look at perpendicular. So otherwise, you can provide an error. Another. Maybe a source of error, if you can use a mechanical stopwatch. A mechanical stopwatch, maybe you shall have an error due to an instrument there. This is so zero error must be considered. But not that, not always zero error, but it depends on what are you using for. For example, I have a digital stopwatch. So that's for the case of the zero error here, it is already minimized. So if you are using the mechanical stopwatch, you should calibrate your stopwatch before starting any experiment. Otherwise, take into consideration that measurement. Okay? Thank you. Until next time, nikukaribishe tu karibu kwenye hiki kipindi. Endelea kufuatilia videos zinazofuata. Usiache kuweka alama ya dole gumba ama kusubscribe. Okay. Asante.